boarded on exiting all trains. Thanks for your cooperation, and thank you for choosing the T.
I've seen her play in Harvard Square, and I've seen her play in the Park Street T.
I've been playing in the subway for about 9 years, and that's about as long as I've been playing.
Well, I saw her out here in the streets for many years, in the subways mostly.
I continue to play in the subway because I love it. I love the pace of change.
Yeah, it's really interesting the way people respond to her compared to some other performers I've seen. Like, people will stop. They'll miss a train or two.
You'll get this little audience of about 7. You'll get on the train, you get a new audience about 10. You get on the train. So you, all night, you know, you've just played to something like 15 to 20 little audiences.
You know, I started seeing her in, like, you know, alternate music magazines, and now I guess she's famous.
One of the benefits about playing in the subway is that if you're working on a song, you can kind of work on that one song all night long.
Without the passengers on these trains, I never would have been able to stay playing, to stay committed to trying to be a musician. So I owe a great deal to the people that take these trains.
A busker is the proper name for a street musician. The first time I ever busked, it happened sort of accidentally. I was living in London, and I lived in a squat, which is a little apartment that you kind of live there for free, but it might have no heat. So anyway, to avoid going home to the freezing squat, I used to hang out in the subway after school and watch the buskers, and I made friends with this one busker, Mark. And Mark asked me one day to watch his equipment when he went to the bathroom. So I did, and I picked up the guitar, and I played a D, an A, and a G. And in the middle of the D, A, G, someone threw a pound coin. And I said, oh, so this is what it's all about. It's been really great. I'm doing a promotional tour, but it's been working out really well. I'll get to a town. I'll set myself up maybe on a college campus and play for a few hours and tell people who I am and sing some songs for them and just kind of promote myself a little bit and invite them to the show that I'm doing in the evening. And it's just been amazing how many of the people will come that night and how many people do come.
It's been interesting. It's been really nice to see the response she gets all over the country and in small towns and, you know, places where she may have never been before. And I mean, we really didn't have a bad night on the road.
This is a song about traveling on the broke side. I want to dedicate this song to my mom and dad. Hello, Western Union. Get me mom.
Out of place and incomplete, call it guilt, call it what you will. Kiss goodbye the summer sky, Hollywood and Malibu tides through thick and thin. Got a good friend in me.
It's certainly not as glamorous as most tour jobs might be. I mean, most bands get to the club and they set up and then there's like the big backstage beer spread and everyone's hanging out, but it's just me and her. She doesn't want to just play the club gig. She wants to like lug the amp around the streets for 2 hours trying to find a street corner to play on. And so I carry all the stuff and we get there and then, no, that's not the perfect spot.
Well, I've seen the sunrise from the cliffs at Point Reyes and I've seen it set upon Thunder. Comes in and the stars come out and the highway line
Busking is very important to me because I get a huge sense of freedom when I do it. I'm in control in almost every aspect of it. One of the great pleasures of busking is the people that you meet. It's also that instant gratification of, you know, you play your little number and then they come up with a little gift for you. When you do a show on a stage, you just don't get that same intimate and immediate kind of interaction. You don't actually see how a lot of the people might be responding to the music that you're playing for them. I'll continue to do it always.
We're here in Central Square in Cambridge, Massachusetts. Just up there is Harvard. And just down there is Boston. And this is the Middle East Cafe. I played here last night for their 10th birthday party.
This is a song, this is a new song. It was inspired by an Elvis Presley song, that song being called His Latest Flame. It's the one that goes, her hair was black, her eyes were green, dee 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 dee. Anne Marie's the name of his latest flame. Anyway, this song is called His Lamest Flame, and I have to sing the guitar part for reference. Okay. Don't ask me. Are bent and the hands are clasped, the painted head is bowed. A sudden glimpse to heaven's gate is all that I'm allowed. My hair is black and my eyes are green, but Maria's not my name.
I personally love this new record. It's an honest delivery of a really great group of songs. The musical influences are definitely there underneath the songs. On Seven Sisters, there's a definite John Prine feel going on in that song. What else? Two Boats is a little bit James Taylor-ish to me. It's the adult song on the album. Some Jingle Jangle Morning is a little punky thing that... I lived in Olympia, what can I say, you know? The songs have taught me well, and when you make a record, it's like you've got 10 daughters and this is their wedding day. And you try to make them look as fancy and pretty as you can on their special day, and then you record it, dress it up, and you say, okay, stand still, and then you take the picture. And that's what making the album was kind of like for me. And that's when you let it go into the world and you say, bye, have a good life. And you just pray that they don't get treated too bad, and you know, sometimes you might cover it later, and that's like Christmas or Thanksgiving. It comes back and visits for a while, and you read about it, and you're like, oh, my baby's doing all right. And then somebody might be inspired to write their own songs. So it goes, that's how it works to me. And it's a beautiful thing that music has the power to do that, and the foreverness of it is just amazing.
Thank you. Okay, I got one more song. I'm gonna get the hell out.